I'm borrowing a quote from Professor Lang, the psychiatrist, the late Ronnie Lang, and he said, when you come to think about it, life itself is a terminal condition that is sexually transmitted. Which that's a brilliant. Actually, I do believe that making contact with people is life. All you can do is change the value of your life by human contact. And I think that really counts.
Dr. Robert Buckman is about as far as you can get from the cold and personal image of the medical professional. He's a cancer specialist and author, known for his sensitivity and even humor in helping people cope with life-threatening illnesses.
You really, walk a mile in their moccasins, as it were. You learn how to handle the situation that's developing between the two of you. And although I'm sure all of the doctors looking after me felt sorry for me, he said, you've got this, you've got that, you've got the other, you've got the skin, you've got the muscles. It must be awful for you. I am sorry. And I very nearly burst into tears and hugged him, because he gave me permission to feel ill. And that is a technique I've used many, many times since.
Rob gave us a beautiful example of the fact that we can be healthy even though we are living with one or more chronic diseases, and devoted his life to helping other people do the same.
There was an ancient Greek philosopher, Epictetus, who said, difficult circumstances are the things that show us who we are. And he was right. They show you and others around you what you are made of. In sum, what is revealed is absolutely fantastic and praiseworthy.
He used humor appropriately within his clinical encounters with patients, and I think it really made him human, and it allowed him to have huge connections with the patients. So he used it really, I guess we could call it therapeutically.
You can't cure serious illnesses with humor, but how you cope with serious illnesses can change dramatically.
I think that in the moment that a person makes a joke about a threatening situation, they are actually doing stand-up. And actually, I love the phrase stand-up, because that's exactly what they're doing. You know, the disease or the diagnosis knocks you flat, and you know, everyone else is sort of gobsmacked and you're gobsmacked. And what you actually do is you stand up. And humor is one of the things that will actually help you stand up. So it's a good stand-up comic. It's only television, you don't need a brain for that.
I cured my diabetes by eating wallpaper.
Oh, really? Did you cook it?
No, I ate it straight off the wall.
Oh, very wise.
Should we do again? Just go again?
Yes, and the waiter just grabs the wallpaper and thrusts it down your throat.
Gives you a whole load of other problems as well.
Oh, yes, I'm sure it does. Yes. All that distemper and stuff.
I remember him going the extra kilometers just to make everyone feel very comfortable who came to his group. And it made everyone feel very comfortable, it made the newer people feel very welcome.
Once I became a veteran in Dr. Buckman's program, I used to tell new participants, I walk out of every program feeling lighter and enlightened.
When somebody that we know has died, we give them a sort of immortality by the changes that they have made in us. And when it's our turn to die, we can achieve that same sort of immortality in changing the kind of people that we have touched.